You're watching On the Record, and our guest today is someone who was till last year heading the Integrated Defence Services, which did all the groundwork for the setting up of the position of Chief of Defence Services. That's Vipin Rawat, who has been appointed today. Thank you very much, General Dua, for speaking with Hindustan Times. I want to start off by asking you to explain to us in lay terms just what is the role of the CDS going to be, and if you can give us an instance of how that role will kick in.
In nearly 70 countries in the world, all the three forces, Army, Navy and Air Force, are integrated, and they have a higher defense organization, because today no one's service can go it alone. And there is a lot to be achieved by integration of these services. And India has been rather late in adopting this step of appointing a chief of defense staff who can integrate the three services together. And then that leads to enhancement of combat potential and resource optimization. So this step has come after a long time, and it's a very bold and historic step.
So to put it simply, is he going to be the boss of the three chiefs?
If I say yes, that will be an oversimplification, because for the present moment, our three services are not yet integrated. If you notice, the Gazette notification gives the CDS a mandate to carry out integration, evolve structures within 3 years. So they give him a timeline of 3 years to evolve those structures. But for the present, he will be the principal military advisor. He will head the three services chiefs in collective bodies like the Chief of Staff Committee. But the operational control of all three services will remain with the three service chiefs. So what does he do? He is the sole advisor as far as all tri-service matters are concerned.
What about the Secretary of Defense? Will he report to the CDS?
Negative. You see, the CDS will be the principal military advisor. The Defense Secretary is the defense advisor. Now, where is the difference? Military arguably is the significant or the biggest part of defense. However, defense includes a few other facets. For example, defense also includes the defense industry, which has a separate secretary called Secretary of Defense Production. There is a defense R&D, the DRDO, as is commonly known of. So that is headed by another secretary level officer. There is a Department of Ex-Servicemen Welfare, another secretary level officer. So all these facets, all these departments go through the Department of Defense. Department of Defense is headed by the Defense Secretary. Now, a new department has been created, and that department is called the Department of Military Affairs. Now, that Department of Military Affairs will be headed by the Chief of Defense Staff, ex officio, and this department will have under it all the three services, Army, Navy and Air Force, and as well as the Integrated Defense Headquarters.
Well, some people seem to think that there is going to be an imbalance in reporting. For instance, Congress MP Manish Tiwari has been tweeting, I saw your exchange with him earlier, that who is actually going to be the one calling the shots? If there is a conflict, and who will the Raksha Mantri, the Defense Minister, listen to, him or the three chiefs?
You mentioned a particular tweet. I also explained there. Having been a member of the Chief of Staff Committee myself, I must assure you and assure the country, assure the viewers, that normally the service chiefs are in agreement on operational issues. But if there is a contentious issue, and if someone has to override somebody, then it's a military realm, and the Chief of Defense Staff will on the advice of his advisors, and his advisors, his three inputs he gets also from the three service chiefs. But yes, to repeat myself, if a contentious decision has to be taken, then he must give that correct decision to the leadership. And that is the sole purpose.
Can you give us an example of a situation of conflict, perhaps, where we will see the CDS play a role now that we have a CDS?
We have a very limited kitty. I'm talking of the defense budget. And where it comes to modernization of the three forces or capability development of the services, because the kitty is finite and our requirements are more, the CDS will play a very meaningful role in prioritizing the requirements of the services. So whether we should buy a platform for a particular service first, or we should buy it after we acquire something for the other service first. So that sort of a synchronization will be done by the CDS. Now, in so doing, instead of each service doing things on their own, it will be the CDS who will decide priorities, and in that he might have to take some hard decisions.
Sir, I believe that the original recommendation was to have a 5-star general as a CDS, and General Bipin Rawat is only a 4-star general. What does this difference mean?
It was 20 years ago, or 19 years ago to be precise, that when the group of ministers led by Mr. Advani after the Kargil war recommended the CDS for the first time, the Arun Singh task force that looked after the defense issues brought out the nitty-gritties, and their recommendation was to have a 5-star CDS heading the headquarter integrated defense staff. So to that extent, you're right. However, a lot of time has elapsed. And then in 2011-12, it was Naresh Chandra task force which recommended a 4-star. And of course, they called him a chairman, chief of staff, permanent chairman. But they recommended a 4-star officer. And thereafter, a couple of other committees like Shikhar Committee and other study groups have recommended 4-star. Now, that is the factual matter. My own take is, Sunetra, nowhere in the world today we have a 5-star CDS or a CDF, etc. His being 4-star is actually in no way undermining his position as CDS. Look at the United States. They have tens and twenties of 4-star officers, and they have a huge sort of organization of different combatant commands all over the world. But yet their chairman, Joint Chief of Staff, is also a 4-star. And while other operational commanders are also 4-star, it does not in any case compromise. We in the armed forces are very hierarchical people, whether it is 4-star or 5-star. Would not really matter to our hierarchies. And last sentence, it is better that we don't have a 5-star, because nowhere in the world there is 5-star today in any democracy at least. And so we'll be better off in equating with other countries as well.
And my final question, why is it that the CDS needs his own insignia, his own uniform?
Well, CDS needs a new insignia. He's not wearing a new uniform. As far as I know, and I am reasonably sure that I am right, that it is the new insignia, a belt buckle, because he has to have a couple of differentiating or distinguishing insignias on his uniform that distinguish him from being purely an army officer. His uniform remains when it's General Bipin Rawat is an army officer, so he wears army uniform. Tomorrow, if there's a chief CDS from Navy or Air Force, they'll wear the respective uniforms. But the belt buckle and the insignia, the accoutrements that he wears, have to have some distinction where he incorporates all three services to symbolize that he actually belongs to all three services and not to one service at all.
Thank you, General Dua, for speaking with Hindustan Times. Thanks for explaining things so very clearly.
Thank you.